Boom. Infinity, Infinity. Episode 88. Heroes born. We didn't highlight 86 when you were born.
No.
We should. Shout out 86 episode. I don't even know what we talked about. I think it was a weekly roundup.
Probably.
But yeah, this one was a good one, filled with social media heavy analyses.
Commentaries.
And we started a shirt. We designed a whole new shirt just because it's a podcast. So if you see the shirt now, it'll make sense.
Because of this episode. Yeah.
So pick up the shirt.
Cool.
bit.ly/. Let's just bit.ly/. www.elondo.
Okay. Nice. Here we go.
Two, one, boom, and we're back with another episode of Scrat Gamers. This is your weekly roundup, where we talk about four things that we thought were cool from the week and dissect them as Vish plays video games, hence Socratic Gamers. So, like that intro, I was actually going to say the number of the episode again, but I was like, wait, we're not supposed to talk about the number of the episode. So that was an on-the-fly moment. But anyway, so first on the dog of Vish.
Well, I mean, something happened in New Zealand.
Okay, all right, so I know what happened. There was like a shooting in the mosque, but I didn't really follow it closely. There's been like a lot of support over it.
Well, yeah, with any tragedy that kind of happens, right?
For sure. Is it like the biggest one in New Zealand, or?
Not sure if it's the biggest one, but it's
Is it big?
It's like tragedy. Well, it's relating to something that I like someone I watch, like PewDiePie. Like,
okay.
Kind of like how his name got brought up.
Okay.
So that's mainly the reason why I'm talking about it.
Okay, so what happened?
So, like, I guess there's like, it wasn't just one guy. I think there was multiple people.
Okay.
That went to different mosques in the...
Oh, it was like a coordinated attack?
Kind of, yeah.
Oh, that's crazy. I didn't know that.
Well, 49 people died, right?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, as they were praying, so...
Oh, wow. So it was like amidst the
in the
worship. Oh, that's crazy. All right.
So, but one of the guys who's, 28-year-old.
Oh, that's pretty young.
Yeah. So they're currently investigating this 74-page manifesto thing.
Wait, he wrote a 74-page manifesto?
Something like that. But
he wrote he wrote it?
Yeah. Well, that's what they say. You know, they're looking into if it's him or if it's someone else.
Like, oh, okay.
They're
okay.
Investigating it. Anyways.
Wait, hold on. Pause. So do they think he's the leader? Like, how does that work?
No. I don't know who's the leader, per se. Could be, but who knows?
Okay, all right. Continue.
No, but the point was the manifesto, and it was all filled with, like, memes and things.
What?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and
then... Oh, this is going to tie into my next topic really well.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, it is.
Yeah, okay, go ahead.
So...
Huh.
Yeah, so...
His manifesto is filled with memes.
Yeah.
Okay, there's something wrong with this person.
What? Exactly. And he wrote and posted, like, on social media shortly before the attack, too.
Okay.
Right? And then, like, against Muslims and immigrants or, you know... several references to memes and video games. That's what there's in that book.
Okay. So is he like, was he brainwashed by the memes and then...
Well, he was already like, maybe like mentally unstable and using those things as
part of his... Is it easy to get guns in New Zealand, or like, was it very difficult for him? Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I don't know the actual gun laws in New Zealand.
Okay, so it's not like America where you just go to like a Walmart.
No, I don't think it's that easy. I don't think so.
Okay.
But these guys are like the extreme right, right?
Okay.
So they were... Anyway, so, like, he would post about these things on like 8chan. It's like, you know, there's a 4chan. There's like so many of these weird 8chan
and
things like
okay,
that.
Okay, so it's all like the next level of 4chan.
Okay.
It
says, and it was like time to stop shit posting.
That's what he wrote
in one of his things. Yeah.
Okay.
And time to take real life effort, do something in real life versus just shit posting.
Oh, okay. I understand. So he was saying like we need to stop All right, we apologize for the dog. She wanted to make an appearance. So he was saying like it's not enough to just create like memes. You need to actually take action, and
Well, yeah,
that's what he did.
I think that's that was where,
Wow.
yeah. I think
Okay.
that's where
That's
he
super
was.
intense.
Yeah, he went in that kind of direction, yeah.
Wow. Okay. All right. So this is like one of the pitfalls of like ubiquitous knowledge and like connectivity.
Yeah, I mean,
That's crazy. Wow. Okay. This is like untold problems that nobody foresaw with the internet.
yeah, I mean,
You know what I'm
and
saying? Like,
yeah. And
that's pretty
then,
intense. Okay,
yeah, I
keep going.
mean, again, it's not that, yeah, these are the rare people that come out of this kind of thing with that, from the issues from the internet, right? I
Right,
guess, but
yeah,
it's
for sure,
not
for sure.
like everybody. It's not like that. But
But I guess like you could technically say it's like, okay, if you have a chef's knife and then this person like goes off the wall and they kill somebody with a chef knife, then you're like, oh, we should have regulated chef knives. It's not really about like the regulation. Oh wow, this is really tying well into my next topic. But it's not really about the regulation, it's more about the person. But anyways, keep going.
So, and then the reason I'm bringing this up is because he actually live streamed some of it as a
Oh
first
my
person shooter
God.
kind of view.
Wow.
This is right. Yeah, it's a little bit.
Did the media pick up on this? Like did they realize and put together how like trolling this is?
Yeah, we're using it as this tactic. I don't know.
Like that's a little weird. Okay, keep going.
And then, so as he was filming it,
Like what
live
kind of
streaming it
person like
on Facebook,
You must be thinking that this is not real.
If someone watched it, actually, you know,
No, but I mean like
oh.
as him, as a person, he's probably like, oh, these people aren't real to me. Like why if you were honestly for like what this tells me is that if you were honestly for like rectifying a problem, you wouldn't be taking it to such like social media memes like you know, it's almost like you're trying to gather more attention out of this. You know what I mean? Like it was like a
So it, yeah,
celebrity-ish kind
it's
of
a good
thing.
point. It goes into that later.
Oh, okay.
So in his live stream, so this is where PewDiePie names comes up. Now, some, well, I mean, how would you know if he follows PewDiePie or not, right? I don't know how you would know that.
Look at his
Yeah,
subscriber thing. I don't
exactly. That's
know.
the only way. But like, I mean, public can't know that until that's investigation or whatever,
Okay,
right?
okay.
So anyways, in his thing, he was saying, as he was like shooting up the plays, he was saying subscribe to PewDiePie and using that
Wow.
meme as well.
So maybe it was like you ever see, do you remember Fight Club? And like how they were like going against the establishment? It could be that.
Could be.
Like he was trying to be his own like Tyler Durden version of like, okay, let's create some crazy chaos and like blame it on society's ridiculousness. You know what I mean? Like I could see where he's going with it. That's pretty messed up, but like I could see how that would just bring you down the wrong avenue. You know what I'm saying? Okay, yeah, continue. Especially if he was like watching all those things and like.
So what they're saying is that's what you kind of brought up is like this him creating this manifesto, him creating all these things is now it's increasing the amount of attention. And now the news media is talking about it, and I'm talking about it. Right? So and then the public debating surrounding the tech. It's just and then like now, like really looking into who he is. So this is a way for him also to get
More attention,
more
yeah. That's what I'm
attention,
saying.
heard, and then maybe get some copycats.
Interesting. So he wants copycats, or like, what is
Yeah,
that?
I mean like for his team base in a way, right? Like he would probably want someone to do the same thing that he's done.
Angel, but is he dead?
No.
He's alive?
I think he's alive.
Oh,
I didn't look into
okay.
that. But
I would assume that he like killed
they
himself
did
after
capture
that.
some of them. So I didn't look into this guy specifically, but it was just because of subscribe to PewDiePie that I want to talk about this.
Interesting. Interesting. All right, we're gonna do a quick pause and jump back in. I'm gonna give the dog a little bit of love. One second. And we are back. All right, cool. Dog has been subdued with lots of love.
Okay.
Yeah, all right, so continue.
So yeah, I mean, his thinking, this is the great replacement, immigrants coming in. Like this is how his mentality, like this is the right, if you're like an extremist right wing mentality, also using that. Like it's a built up of things, right?
Where's he from? New
He's
Zealand?
New Zealand.
Oh, okay.
There was, I think one of the shooter was like Australian or something.
And he was, and he's just pissed that immigrants are taking over New Zealand?
Yeah, they're where they view them as invaders.
Wow,
But the funny
okay.
thing is, they were invaders.
But yeah, you mean the New Zealand people?
Yeah.
No, of course. But
But yeah.
what's weird is like we okay, so under that logic, it's like could you not also understand like people in like other countries where like let's say like Afghanistan where the Americans are going in like and then you know what I mean? It's like yeah, they're invaders too. So we're falling under the same lines here. You know what I'm
Yes.
saying?
Agreed.
Yeah. It makes sense how he could have been pushed to this level.
Oh, yeah. No,
It's
no, no, no.
just
Of course, of
like,
course.
shouldn't have pushed it to that level. That's
Yeah.
super.
But I mean, if he's already unstable, that's the thing, right?
Yeah, totally, totally.
It's gonna
Or
happen.
we don't know. Maybe he wasn't unstable. Maybe something happened.
Maybe,
Maybe
maybe,
like,
maybe. That's what the investigation is for, right?
right, like maybe his entire wife and family got shot up by immigrants. You know what I mean? Like a Punisher sort of style, where it's like, I'm gonna take my revenge, etc. Anyways, yeah.
So yeah, and then him bringing up PewDiePie and all that stuff. So PewDiePie had to have a response,
Oh, really? He
because
had a
he,
response?
well, yeah, because, I mean, this is it was live streamed and him saying subscribe to PewDiePie kind of puts him in the limelight already. Who's had, controversial things with the
Yeah, I
media.
remember. Yeah.
So on top of that, he had to, so his what he was saying was just, like he was feel sickened by having my name uttered by this person. Like I think it was like my heart and thoughts go out to the families of the victims and things like that. So like he had to say
Yeah,
something.
okay, I understand. Did you put it in a video or was it just like a
No, it
tweet?
was a tweet.
Oh,
It was a
okay.
tweet. Yeah. He might put it in a video, but again, he already films those videos prior to them being
Release, yeah,
released.
I
So.
got you. Interesting. Very interesting. It's weird how social media has totally taken over like the culture and its implications are so far-reaching.
Yeah, I mean, world reaching.
Yeah, world-reaching. Yeah, definitely. They have like some huge consequences.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, so is that the end of your topic?
Yes.
So I was checking out the Tim Pool slash Jack Dorsey slash I forgot that last lady's name, but like it was basically Twitter, the Twitter CEO, and then the head of like,
Communications or something?
yeah, something like that,
Yeah.
policing people on the platform, and like Tim Pool was there to talk about like alternate views, and then Joe Rogan was the mediator in between it.
Yeah.
Really good podcast. I think I've got like a little bit left, but what I want to get to is like this whole idea of policing social media,
Yeah.
right? And the way. Like, I get it, you know? Like, the way.
Yeah. Sorry. I
The
didn't.
way social media works is like,
Yeah.
you sign up for this thing, you fully agree to them having control, and then you use the platform accordingly, right?
Yeah, to their rules, yeah. Basically, right?
It's a privilege, not a right.
Yeah.
Right? So it's sort of like driving. It's like, okay, you have to read the rule book before getting your license, then you can drive.
Yeah.
But if you cause so many problems, you don't actually get to drive anymore. You get banned from the platform of driving. Just like you get banned from the platform of Facebook or like iTunes. You know what I'm saying? And like the way like the leftist view was is that like, oh, they're trying to silence free speech, right? And then listen to that podcast. It's like, no, it was like a
Actually, it's
conglomeration
also the
of
right point of view too, though. Not
that
just the
they.
this is,
But I'm saying like Tim Pool is more lefty than.
he's more lefty, but a lot of the complaints come from the right,
Okay, well, whatever. Yeah,
saying that
sorry.
the Twitter
Yeah,
is
because
too
they're
lefty.
the ones being banned. Yeah,
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
yeah,
That's
yeah.
what he was presenting. He's like, you guys are
Well.
more left-leaning, blah, blah, blah. But it's like, anyways, so. But like with that, it's like you agreed to the rules of the platform prior to.
Yeah, no one reads those through, but yeah.
Yeah, no one reads them, but it's like you still have to do your due
Yeah,
diligence.
of course.
It's almost like saying, like, oh, I didn't read the handbook for driving and I killed a bunch of people. But I didn't read it though, so
Yeah.
I can get scot-free. You know what I mean? Like an absence of knowledge is not,
Yes.
a viable reason. So, like, in that, like, what do you think about social media policing and all that?
I mean, I don't think it's
Like, I see
policing
it like a
in which way,
business.
like, yeah, exactly. It is a business right now, and then
But like, it's not like utility. So like, I
it's
guess what they're trying to like say it's like is like water companies, right? And it's like, okay, water is a utility, so everyone has the right to access it, et cetera, et cetera. But still, if you don't pay your bill for water, you're like, there's an agreement, right? The agreement is I'll pay you money, you will give me water. The agreement is you will follow my terms and then you can use the platform. So it's like you're just not adhering to what's been said. Like, it's almost like a kid that wants their cake and eating it too. You know what I mean? It's like those are the rules of the platform though. So why try and argue it to be f free? 'Cause then I could do the same for you. It's like, no, I feel like you should do this for me. And like, well, no, I don't want to do that for you. Yeah, but I want it. It just seems like that, you know? It's like you just have this person that's like not involved in the platform screaming at the top of their lungs about how much they want it. But it's like, yeah, you gotta agree to it though. It's like it's a transactional trade. You know what I'm saying? Anyways. Yeah, what do you think?
I mean, the only way to, yeah, I guess if it's becomes a platform where everyone in a specific country is using it, then does then where the government get involved to protect freedom of speech?
Yeah, you can't have rules in across different countries.
No, I'm saying per country. They already do that.
They have rules per country.
So if China has these sort of things, or they would block, or like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but see, okay, so the platform, so
Or a
China,
block, or they would have
that's what I'm saying. No,
to,
but so China is using their own inter they're not meddling with Twitter. They're just blocking that communication.
No. I mean, like, there are other things where I know what you're saying. What I'm saying is where it becomes too big. You know what I mean? Like a monopoly of
Yeah, but it's not.
speech. It's not there. I'm not saying it's
But
there.
okay, yeah.
I'm saying if it gets to that
But
point,
even if
then
it does
would
get,
that be where they would need to get involved?
no, because even if it gets to that point, it's still owned by. So it
I
that,
know, I
that
know. I'm
that's like
just saying
saying that's
it's
like
a whole
saying.
new thing. This is the whole internet
No, but
thing.
that's like all business things. It's like if you get too successful, then you lose your business. That makes no sense.
They would break them up, yeah. That's what's gonna happen to Amazon if they become too big.
Okay.
That's what happens. That's what the monopoly is, right?
But like
If it becomes a monopoly, they have
there
to.
are other outlets.
I know, but that's what I'm saying. What the same thing with Amazon, right? If they become
Okay,
more
but
than.
this isn't about breaking it up though. This is like, okay, whatever legal precedents, whatever, whatever. That's not actually about that. It's actually it's what it is like these people want something out of a platform that they've fully agreed to.
I know.
They has not like it's
Exactly,
the
I
government can
know.
do whatever it wants, yeah, or issue regulation, whatever, whatever. But it's like, why argue
I'm
for
just saying,
something
yeah,
that
I
you've
know.
willfully signed up for? You don't have to sign up for the platform. You know? Oh, but then we won't be a part of it. So then you want to be a part of the platform. So play by the rules of the platform. It's like saying, oh, I don't want to take public transit. I want to drive. You know? So it's like, okay, so adhere to the rules of driving then. You know? Or take public transit, which sucks. You know? So it's like just use a different Twitter alternative. You can make status updates on Facebook. You know? That's just how I feel.
No, I agree. I was just saying, trying to say a different kind of point. Maybe that could help them. I'm just saying. Not necessarily I agree with that, just
But
as a
like,
method of
I just it's just like
like
when you
how could
listen to people who are arguing about it, and it's like, oh, that makes sense as to what you're arguing for. But then you listen to it from like a logical business perspective, it's like, no, they make more sense. You're just like,
I
you know what
watched
I
that.
mean?
I watched that bit, and I agreed with the with Twitter people.
Yeah, I agreed with the Twitter people too. Like, Tim Pool just seemed a bit salty. That's all.
It's their platform. It's their company. They can do what they want.
Yeah, exactly, totally. Or else, where do we stop? You know what I mean? Like, if you start doing that to Twitter, then like, then everything becomes regulated, because you can make the argument, you know. And I think that's the line that we're trying to see if we're gonna cross, because like the way legal systems work, it's like on
Like, I mean,
precedence.
even yeah, and
So
then
if this gets away with it, then they could recall this as like Twitter versus the public, and then you know what I mean? Then they use it as a means to like get their way for other things. So it's like you're opening the door to Pandora's box.
Like, I mean, even with companies' political points, that also doesn't matter, right? Like the complaint from the right would be that, oh, Twitter or like Facebook, you're too left wing, but what does that matter?
And totally. And it's also like a small minority that's making, 'cause like they said one of the statistics is like if you've been banned, if you not banned, sorry, if you've been like put on suspension, like 2 out of 3 of those people will adhere to, like they're like, oh, okay, I didn't know that. I'll fix my behavior next time,
I saw that
right?
part, yeah.
But it's like, okay, but the only people that are really complaining are the ones that want to continuously break those rules. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, I want to keep cutting to the front of the line. No, but there's a queue. No, but I want to cut out of the line because I'm selfish. Like, what? You know what I'm
Right,
saying? Just like, yeah, it just seems like whining.
Yeah, but for the, yeah, I agree with that, I mean, like, yeah, I don't know. I mean, the most that was affected anyone, it's been only Alex Jones, at least I can think of.
Yeah, from what they've said,
Yeah,
yeah, totally.
but outside of that, I don't think anyone else
And when
really.
either like, oh, you're being biased because like, what about this person that issued death threats and then you didn't block them? It's like, okay, that was our choice though. But they couldn't come right out and say it, but it was like,
But it's
that's
not
kind
just
of what they're
not
implying,
no,
you know?
but it's
It's
not
like,
necessarily their choice, but it's like
no, but it is their choice. It's
no,
like,
what I
it's my platform,
no,
bro.
no, I know, I know, but what they were saying also was like, well, people didn't report it, or like how
No,
they
totally,
how,
100%.
like
Yeah,
it's not
people didn't
like
report it.
it's not like they
Exactly. Yeah.
didn't, if someone broke it, they would follow through. It's just also someone's gotta bring it up to them too, right?
Totally.
So
But like Tim Pool's like, you should be like more like on it. It's like, all
okay.
right, you create, how about you create an app
Yeah.
that everyone will want to use,
Right.
and then we'll see how you handle the situation. You know what I'm saying? It's like
Yeah, it's a big thing. Is how many people use it? So it's even you know as much an algorithm can
it's more about
work, it's there's also problems with that.
emotional opinion versus logical understanding. That's what I got from that.
On certain things, yeah, I think this was the one case that I disagreed with Tim Pool on.
Yeah, I like him as a reporter. He's awesome. Cool guy. Anyways, what's your next topic?
Well,
Was it tying to this one?
there's still, I mean, okay, so, it is, well, I did go to social media to try to find more information.
Okay. Oh, wow. So that's the link right there. All right.
Okay, but that was like, so the day that like my first topic was about, that happened, I was only going on to social media to find out more about what happened that previous night, which was the announcement of Tesla's Model Y. So anyway, that's the only reason why I went into the PewDiePie thing, because I was, first of all, wasn't looking for that, but it just happened that way. Like just like what trends on the internet, right?
I
So
understand,
yeah.
understand.
So anyway, so Model Y was announced,
Nice.
and well, it's the next. So now he can actually spell out the word that he's been trying to spell out,
Okay.
which is the Model S, Model X. Well, it will be the Model E, which was the 3, and then now the Model Y. So he spelled out.
Sexy.
He's
That's funny.
just.
He's a total troll. I
He's a
love
toy.
it.
Yeah, that's the thing
He's
with
so
him.
ingeniously a troll, not a flamethrower. You know what I mean? Like, okay, we can ship these different countries, so we're gonna call it not a flamethrower.
See,
Or the boring company. You know, like that's so trolly, but like awesome. He's a
So,
very ballsy individual. Whereas like Steve Jobs was very creative and ingenious. Not saying that he's not creative and genius, but like he's way more ballsy than he's like the real life Tony Stark.
he was in that Iron Man
He was, yeah, totally was.
movie.
Anyways, yeah,
Because
continue.
yeah, that was the meme. So basically, he showed off all the cars that they've been doing from the year when they started. And I didn't
This
know
was their
this.
promotion?
No, this is like the lead up to showing off the Model Y.
Okay, cool.
So I didn't know this when he was saying in this presentation that when they made the first Model S, they took a small portion of the building in the rocket building,
Oh, no way.
and that's
That's
where
kind of
they
cool.
built it.
Huh. Okay.
Yeah. So, and then basically, like the announcement for the Model Y was in the very small segment near the end of the video. The whole other part was just what they've done and how far they've reached now, right?
Okay.
And one thing I found was kind of interesting because he brought up a few quotes from companies back in 2001-ish, 2000. Oh no, sorry, 2009, 2011.
Okay.
And what they used to say then was, "This is from Forbes. Electric cars are an extraordinarily bad idea."
Huh.
And then the quote from Los Angeles Times was, "More like a glorified golf car than a harbinger of tomorrow tech." Yeah.
Okay.
So just straight up attacks. And then, sorry, but electric cars are a waste of space.
Wow.
That was from the Daily Mail. Yeah. And then now, in 2019 or in 2017 and 2018, quotes are, this is like from Wired, these are tech websites, I guess. "General Motors is going all electric.
Huh, okay. Trends have changed.
Ford is all in on electric cars."
Huh.
Or goes all in, yeah. And then Volkswagen is betting its future on electric cars.
Oh, wow. Okay, there you go.
So here's that shift that happened.
He was just ahead of his time.
Yeah, but that's the thing. Like at that time, you just didn't have an idea of like what an electric car could be,
Yeah, totally. This is a great
right?
example of hurting the masses. Like, it's like people, if you look at the marketing of it,
So yeah, go ahead.
so there's like a small percentage of people that have a vision that's so strong that they're able to cut right through the illusion and like enact their vision, right? He's one of those people. And like, but what we do with the masses is we provide marketing, which is like we lobby to them to get them on our side. It's all about like who's got the best idea and how quickly can you sell that idea. You know what I mean?
True.
Has nothing to do with like what's real, but what's easy to push in people's minds.
Yeah.
You know?
So, like, I mean, yeah, if people just thought that the way they thought 10 years ago,
We
nothing would have
wouldn't have this.
changed.
Exactly. Yeah, totally. Actually, this is a great segue into my next topic, but continue.
Okay. So, it's just like, it's great to see, you know, the change and where electric cars have come now, right?
Yeah, totally.
That it's now, it's inevitable, like it's inevitable.
Yeah,
That
no, of
idea is
course, yeah.
inevitable now.
It is inevitable, yeah.
I mean, it wasn't easy at first, right? So that's the
Mm-hmm.
thing with Tesla was any car company is tough
Yeah, for
because
sure.
it's you're competing with people that are been here for years.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
So to see that happen was kind of cool. So then at the end of that segment, he announced the Model Y. The same. It has a front design very similar to Model 3.
Is it cheaper than the Model 3?
No.
Oh, damn.
No. Because it's an SUV. SUVs can't, won't be cheaper than
Oh, okay. Yeah. I didn't know it was an SUV.
Yeah, it's an SUV, Model Y. It's in between like the Model 3 and the Model X, that
Okay.
size, in
Oh,
between
okay,
that.
cool. Yeah.
So, and then has the same usual panoramic glass roof.
Oh, that's cool.
And then, so this thing would have seven seats
Oh, that's
versus
pretty
a
cool.
normal, because an SUV is a or five seats, right, normally.
Yeah.
And then, well, American dollars. The one that they're showing off was the this was a long range one they were showing off, so which is 300 miles, and at $47,000.
Oh, that's not
It's
bad.
not bad. It's not
No,
bad.
that's
It's not
not
bad.
bad. Not
Actually,
like
for an
60.
SUV,
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
not bad.
Yeah.
American.
But
Let me
still,
add
like
that.
60,000 for other cars. That's not bad at all.
Yeah.
That's
So,
like that's pretty
yeah.
expensive, but it's like okay.
Yeah, well, they will make a little bit lower range one in, I think, so this one will be released in 2020, fall
Okay.
of 2020, and then the other, They will make a shorter range, which would be about $36,000.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah.
That's
36
not bad
or 39, problem. I can't remember now. Yeah. So, and it's not like, it's not just, you know, the Model Ys. He's got the Model S, X, E, and Y now, and uh-huh. also the new Roadster.
Uh-huh.
And then the trucks.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's another thing we can't forget. Mm-hmm. He's also getting in the truck field.
Yeah.
Right? So, it's...
Actually,
the thing is, he's got to stay on point, stay on time. And
no, for sure, for sure, for sure. Actually, this is ingenious.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, sorry. You continue your thing, and then I'm about to segue to my thing.
No, I was just going to add, like, now, at this point, they've got over 12,000 plus superchargers.
Mm-hmm.
So a great way to, you know, like, that's the thing that nobody else has right now. No other company or, like, other electric car companies, like, who's going to get involved in it?
For sure.
Don't have that, right? And across 36 countries, so it's interesting. Yeah. So, yeah, you go ahead with yours.
Okay, so this is actually super ingenious because if you look at it from his eyes, how do you herd the masses to make them stop climate change?
Yeah.
Okay, so I've been thrust into the whole climate change debate recently, and I have to like cover it, et cetera, et cetera. So like I've been listening to people's solutions, and they're always like so they're like very monotonous, and they're very like rote. Like they're always the exact same thing.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, how are you gonna stop climate change? Well, the simple things that we could do, we could take the bus to work, or we could like, you know, not use our cars as often, but we can carpool. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then so I was like, okay, or like you can plant a lot of trees in your backyard, and like, you know, so I'm like, okay, first of all, that's an affluent solution.
Yeah.
You know, second of all, does that really make a difference? So I was doing some research on it. So Canada is actually a contributor of 1.58% to total climate change.
Okay.
The biggest contributor is China, which is pretty evident, at like 27%, something like that. And then the next under that is USA, which is like 27%. I can't remember the exact numbers.
Yeah.
But like they're substantially higher than 1.58%. So to reprimand an entire country over climate change, like what are you really solving? See what I'm saying? It's like a red herring. You just make them focus on something that they actually can't solve or really contribute to.
Yeah.
In order to get other things, like, you know what I mean? Like we'll just occupy their minds with this thing called climate change, and then we'll, you know, et cetera, we'll like control them other ways.
Yeah.
Right? But if you look at it like Elon Musk's way, it's like, okay, I just provide you with a better solution because it's the industry's fault, not your fault.
Yeah.
You don't reprimand anyone.
No.
It's like, I'm just going to try and make the cheapest cars. Because when he was on Joe Rogan, he's like, oh, what about like an AC system that knows that you're not home and will shut itself off?
Because
that's another way to save on climate change.
Exactly. Yeah. It's yes.
So it's like you're not putting the onus on the people because they're just the hurt. You're just hurting the masses.
Yeah.
You're putting the onus on yourself, who's awake enough to make those decisions.
To make. Yeah, exactly.
You know,
I think that's the only way that this thing's
gonna work. And I was like, yeah, like why are you pushing it on the like the lowly among us who've got other problems? Leave that to like smarter people to solve, which is what I believe Elon Musk is doing. I think he's looking at our species as a problem to be solved. You know, and I think he's got some really great solutions.
Yeah, I agree.
But he also like from listening to him and stuff, he also thinks we're very deluded as a species.
Yeah.
You know, he's always, like, making, like, even with calling it SEXY, he's just trolling. Like, he's just showing you how ridiculous the system is.
Yeah.
You know? And, like, the way he talks about, like, if you just listen to that Joe Rogan podcast, it's very, like, humans are, he doesn't seem human. He seems robotic. Because he's seeing the flaws of humanity.
Yeah.
You know, and he's trying to logically work his way through it, and which is why he's coming up with these great solutions without telling you their solutions.
Right. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because if you market it as a solution, then you're dealing with so many other problems. You're going against the oil industry. Right. So the second interesting fact is Canada's. So like it's like, okay, we got to stop climate change. So it's like, okay, well, we aren't contributors to that much climate change. So like, what else can we do, right?
Right.
I found out that Canada's leading industry is car manufacturing. $47 billion a year going to car manufacturing. And the second one on that is aviation at $7 million. That's a 40, a 7 billion. So that's a $40 billion differential between 47 billion and 7 billion to the next one. So obviously your biggest export and way of making money as a country is car manufacturing, right? So how are you going to not only tell us that we're bad, even though we only, like as a populace, even though we only contribute 1.58%, but you're also cutting us at the kneecaps because you're not letting us, like our major industry is a contributor to climate change. So it's like you can't actually solve this problem from a person level. You can only solve it from a systemic level, which is why I think Elon Musk is a genius. Because he's doing it for the people that are actually looking at it. Like I'm really trying to look at it from like his perspective, and it's like that is what you're doing. You're not telling us that's what you're
Exactly,
doing,
exactly.
but that is what you're doing. You know? You're combating climate change in the most effective way possible and not telling us that we're bad because we're not jumping on board. He's like, you don't even have to buy it. Remember? He's like, it's just a fun car. Remember that? He's like, oh, it can even
That's what it should
dance.
be,
It
yeah.
can dance to a song or something. He's like, we put Easter eggs in it. He was like on Joe Rogan saying that like, if you know how to plan it, you can play like the symphony and then the car will dance for you. Remember that? So it's like, yeah, you're just trying to make the most entertaining and best product.
Make it fun, yeah.
Yeah, but without telling people that in purchasing this product, you're solving climate change. He's never used that as a part of his marketing. You know why? Because then you put yourself into the climate change deniers and the believers. You know what I'm saying? Because like, it's like camps. That's especially when you look at people who talk about climate change online. People fall into one of two camps and they'll die to defend it. Either they believe in climate change or they don't believe in climate change. But he's like, I'm not even a part of that argument. You guys can argue all you want and occupy yourselves. All I'm saying is, this is a really sick car and the other ones are archaic. You know? And in this conversation, it's like, oh, well, are you a climate change believer or denier? I just don't think
It doesn't matter.
it does. Yeah, well, yeah, totally. It doesn't matter. But also, I don't think the loud minority, what do you call it? Vocal minority is going to solve this problem. You're just going to spin your wheels for nothing. You know? Okay, it's happening. How do we move forward? And I think you should take that perspective with everything in life, you know? Just like, all right, it's happening. How do you move forward? Genius, genius. Who do you like better, Elon Musk or Steve Jobs? We're gonna
I
be
think I
we're on
said this
record. We're on
before.
record right now,
I know, I
so
think I said
you're
this
gonna
before.
say,
No, I
all
think I said this before.
right. So who you like?
Elon Musk.
Oh no way, better than Steve Jobs.
Steve Jobs had his time. He did what he needed to do.
True.
Elon Musk is now.
He's like 2.0.
Yeah, Elon Musk is the world changer.
I guess I still like Steve Jobs better.
Or actually, Elon Musk is, I would say, the change, like the for humanity in a way.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah. Like Steve Jobs opened the door for creativity.
Yeah,
And
a
then,
different way of thinking, yeah.
yeah, and then Elon Musk is just taking it to the next level. He's like, okay, let's take this open door and let's spread it to the masses. Yeah. Cool guy. I still like Steve Jobs better. Because he
Okay.
came before. It's like,
I know,
you
but
know?
it's just what,
I love Elon Musk, but I'm just saying, like,
just what Elon has
you gotta
done
respect. Give
and still
respect. He's a
doing.
pioneer. Steve
Yeah.
Jobs is
Of
a
course,
pioneer.
of course, but his legacy is done, right?
True. I just like giving respect to him.
Okay.
All right. So, any
Not saying
final
I don't
thoughts?
like him, I'm just saying.
No. Of course. Any final thoughts?
Yeah, but I don't want to say it.
Okay. All right. My final thought is,
Because it's a joke, but it's a bad joke to say.
okay, sounds good. My final thought is focus on what you can change moving forward, not on the inhibitions keeping you back.
Okay.
be Elon Musk, everyone. We should make those t-shirts or like bracelets or something like that. You know, like what would Elon do?
Probably there, but yeah, we should do one.
And Steve Jobs' life.
Okay.
That'll be the two of them. Steve Jobs' life and what would Elon do?
Yeah.
All right. Till next time. Take it easy.
Peace.